Hi, welcome to Numerics Video Blog. I'm your host, Jim Jocko. With me today, Mohit Agrawal, Director of Financial Validation Engineering for Numerics. Mohit, welcome.
Hey, thanks, Jim.
We've been talking about many thematic issues on this video blog, especially around aggregate risk measures. And, you know, we've been focused on a lot of the challenges in terms of technology, whether it's compute, whether it's quantitative issues down to granular elements like, the FEA calculation, as well as operational management. And one of the things I really wanted to talk to you today is advancements that are being made in simulation technology, specifically Monte Carlo. Mm-hmm. And I know you've recently worked on a paper looking at counterparty credit exposure benchmarking in traditional brute force implementations of Monte Carlo, as well as versus an American Monte Carlo, which is relatively new to the market. Can you give us a little bit of a background on the differences of these two flavors of Monte Carlo?
Definitely, Jim. When we talk about counterparty credit exposure, we are talking about exposure distribution for a portfolio. And basically, there are two methods out there in the market. One is the scenario approach, or you can call it as a brute force way, and the other is it's relatively new, as you rightly mentioned, the American Monte Carlo. I mean, it's been there for the insurance industry. It's been there for a while, and now Numerics has its own implementation. We call it algorithmic exposure approach. So the study was really to compare how these two approaches compare in terms of accuracy and speed.
So what is the trade-off? So the brute force really has been the tradition and probably fast enough and accurate enough as it relates for vanilla instruments, mm-hmm. but I guess as you're bringing more exotics into the portfolio, there's significant performance issues.
Yep.
Is it in both in speed as well as accuracy, or is it a speed issue with a brute force approach?
When we talk about the brute force approach, it's basically two steps. So in the first step, you would generate future market scenarios. So the output would be the number of future market scenarios would be equal to the simulation paths you run your Monte Carlo for. And in the next step, you would want to price your portfolio on each of these scenarios. So basically, when you talk about vanillas versus exotics, so vanillas, you have a closed form solution, so it's not much of a pain. The number of calculation is not that much, but when you...
And is that down at the pricer level, in terms of utilizing analytic pricers?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, but when we talk about exotics, you would really want to run a nested simulation. That's basically Monte Carlo over Monte Carlo when you want to do brute force exposure for an exotics portfolio. So, I mean, it becomes very computationally challenging.
So basically, if I'm understanding correctly, mm-hmm. you have 1,000 scenarios that you're running on the pricing of the exotic, which gets overlaid against the thousands of scenarios that you're running.
For market scenarios.
Right. So now the American Monte Carlo, help me understand it. It does it one set of paths that are redistributed against the model?
So American Monte Carlo is basically based on... We can also call it like long staff sorts method or regression or a rollback. There are multiple names of this method. So what it does is basically it uses the same Monte Carlo passage for market scenario as well as pricing. So you technically avoid the nested simulations here. So it uses regression or rollback method to find the exposures on the observation dates.
So looking at your study, and on those two parameters of speed as well as accuracy, what were some of the key findings that you're finding in terms of performance enhancements, and is there any leakage, for lack of a better term, in terms of the accuracy in those calculations?
So in terms of speed, the American Monte Carlo, I saw 15 times advancement compared to brute force. And in terms of accuracy, I would say in brute force, it's really not possible to use complex models at the second step when you are talking about a portfolio of deal of both vanilla and exotic. But with Numerics algorithmic exposure, you can use our hybrid framework, and it's possible to use the same models for pricing as well as risk. So it takes into account the correlations are between the asset classes as well as with the counterparty. So it's more accurate in terms when you talk about aggregating risk exposure at the portfolio level.
Excellent. Well, Mohit, thank you so much for this background, and I'm looking forward to reading fully the study, which will be shortly available on numerics.com for those who are interested in getting through the full report. Again, we are always interested in hearing what you're saying, so please follow us along on Twitter at NXAnalytics or on our blog on numerics.com. Mohit, thank you, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks.